Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to Pico on my shoulder while I dig around in Lifeless Planet. Is that the canyon that I went down into already, or is that a different one? Shit, I can't remember. Anyway, we have arrived in this very vibrant area. We actually have like a mission, kinda, sorta. We're supposed to follow around the girl who keeps appearing on the rocks, but I mostly spend my time digging around on the landscape trying to find the collectible doodads. And all this is fueled by paranoia that I might have missed some. And or the doodad counter might be faulty, or maybe reset per session. And since I don't know that, I am totally paranoid and I'm quadruple checking every nook and cranny. Also, I just want to look around. Oh, and in this area, I've been told by helpful protagonist that we need to watch out for magma chambers. I presume magma chambers are marked by those perfectly circular reddish, darkish spots. Also the hot spring that resembles the whatever it's called in Yellowstone. I bet if we go in there, we get killed. And yet it is so tempting. Just look at it. Look at it. Just a tip. Yeah. Confirmed, I guess. Okay, so where are we again? We start off in this plateau, having come from there. I'm gonna check out these little formations. Like knuckle bones. Okay, this is the canyon that I already checked out. So this and the other one both are easily accessible and easily exitable. That's a word. And I take it we need to eventually get over there. But I have not yet explored to my heart's content, so we're not going there yet. Ah yeah, this is the area where we came from. That's the blue salt stream that looked like ice. And among other things, we get to use hot water jets to bounce around. So that's like natural jetpack. This one's probably deadly. Doing a little round around the perimeter. Checking what's the doodad status. Do we have something there? Is it poop? Aww. Yeah, I think I already checked this one, but since I took a break between this episode and previous one, I will be double checking and double tracking certain things because I don't remember where I did something already. I do think I took a break pretty much after entering this area, so These steps are handy. Well, footsie. I think these circular patches show where magma is underneath. Although we might need that geyser to give us some boost. So there is that. And now I don't remember if I check this ravine as well, so I will double check. I marvel at all the colourful minerals and rocks and shit. Like I think I checked it, but I'm not sure, so there you go. Yeah, okay. Now I'm sure I checked it. At least once. So this is where we get back up. Oh, the blood toes are so cute. Splooshing and splashing around. I hypothesized that this is another magma bubble indication here. These rocky formations have so far been proven safe to interact with, safe to touch. A little geyser! Do we get a boost from this one? No. I see how it goes. Okay. It seems that artifacts are absent from this particular area. Can I just go up from here? Like, I should be able to do that. Or maybe not. I mean, my jumpy skills should... should allow me to conquer this rock from this spot. Maybe not. Okay, let's try from that end. No! Don't overshoot. Shoot it. Oh, we almost fell into the beautiful pit of deadliness. One thing with all the jumping that kind of leads to the dark side is that especially when I'm in a hurry, I sometimes overshoot the targets. That's like extra lame. Oh, we have another plateau. this area is like a proper geyser valley. Okay, there's one path going from here. What's that? Oh, just another one of those rocks. When I first saw them, I thought we might be dealing with scattered documents, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Okay, let's go look at that water. Because I can. Can I get up to the top of this one? Which I might. I mean, I'm probably not supposed to, but who knows? I don't know. It looks pretty accessible. Like, there are certain points where I'm not sure if it's supposed to be accessible to the player, or if I manage to outsmart the terrain. Whoa. I think, okay, invisible boundary here, so we're at the edge of playable area. This mineral-rich area, so far no artifacts. Come on, game. Thunk. I mean, he did take note of those large mineral deposit formations, but that's not the same. Those are not collectible. Those are just played science, not collectible science. What's happening here? Rift in the world. Was that like a shadow line or something? Weird. Oh, okay. I think we have again reached the limit of the playable area. Okay. I will behave. Mostly. Crunchy. But yeah, looking at this area gives me the idea that the formation that we climbed across a few episodes back, that I originally thought was a glacier, that might have been a salt formation as well. Okay, so this is where we should end up. We will do it properly, all the jumps in the room and everything, because certain cutscenes probably depend on proper timing. Just a wild guess. So some loud noises from that way. What was that all about? A waterfall? Rockfall? It sounds loud, deep, and high. Slices of stone or whatever. Looks like a skull. this angle. Okay, we have reached to this end here. So let's take a look at the central formation. Steps go over there. Oh, oh my. Oh well. Pretty. That's a tad far away for a single jump, isn't it? Okay, apparently not. Well, we're getting higher and higher. Interesting. I wonder if there would have been a way. I think I could have just climbed up on this side anyway, so it's maybe not as crucial to do the jumps here. I don't know. Must be a big geyser there. Yeah, yeah, I can see the. What? What? Oh. Oh my. Volcanic lair. Ah, so this is not water droplets that are falling. This might be volcanic ash, perhaps. Swoosh! Stones. Kill two geysers with two stones. Hey. Oh, yo. Don't get stuck. This location reminds me of the fire giant's treasure lair. I don't know, not just fire giants, the area where you fight some fire giants and then a dragon and or steam.
Woohoo!
Uh-oh. I sense volcanic activity. Whoa-ho-ho, hello. I'll probably best put the light on. Also, let's see, options? Let's try this. Oh, there's... Shit. I didn't notice this option. Well, it's too damn late now. I mean, I am competing with the actual daylight shining into my window, but I can do this. Hi. I know that I keep prattling on about how certain aspects of the game remind me of other games and so on, and other works, and other movies and books, but I'm having one of those moments again, and some of those moments are probably intentional references, some of them might be just random, but the whole exploding, erupting volcano in the background reminds me of the Soviet movie series In the Search of Captain Grant, where the plucky protagonists have all the adventure, like all the time, and there's condors flying, abducting people, and there's pirates, and there's let me think, jungle, I suppose, and there's also a volcano. Okay, should I go here? Probably not. But what if there's doodad? Yoink! This is a fire hazard. Okay, I should probably not venture in there. Uh-oh! Like I said, fire hazard. Okay, we already have the doodads now, so I won't even have to go down there. But I will, because what if I miss something?
That's a bit toasty. Well, at least it's a dry heat.
Okay, so I suppose don't step into anything that actively burns. Okay, do not step into those. Noted. Where am I? Okay, here. Okay. toasty. There are some collectibles among all the lava stuff. Oh wait, there was a road going through here all along. Oh, okay. Why did I go up there then? Where we came from. Okay, so let's look around. There are other places to be. Okay, there's a landmark. And there's a path. There's a path. Oh. done good. We get a save point. Too close to the floor. This is dangerous. Yeah, this is wrong. That's where I came from. Wait, what's this one? Closer to the thingy, to the pylon. Landmarks are marky. There's the other path. Wait, should we go to the pylon? Let's check it. Okay, it's a dead end, so it was just directional, I guess. It's probably very hot. Supposed to use the lava flow to jump somewhere. Oh no, I think we just have to block it. Bombarded by lava. I am totally gonna dig around and look for artifacts. That coughing was unnerving. Was it the protagonist or was it the girl? Oh shit! Okay, I guess the game doesn't want us to go there. Where were we? Did I check that corner? Yes, I did. Okay, let's carry on. Uh-oh. Oh no.
Помоги, подними. Хватит, наверх.
To check for artifacts now, huh? Think what you're doing. Okay, let's look around very briefly. Danger. 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 Strings and cushioning for two, so I'm not concerned. Oh, okay, this is a secluded area anyway. Okay. Let's see, from here, we need to go over there. Gotcha. So from here to there. Saved a day, saved a girl, and you're out of jetpack fuel.
So, that explains how she's able to breathe the atmosphere.
Green goop is life. Green goop is science. That's all the explanation you need. Some of these mountainous areas seem to be explorable. Guiding us now. How about some artifacts? Wait for her. yellow. Oh, the gate doesn't seem to be powered, which means we will have to... Yo. Okay, I gotcha. We need to turn this shit on. Well, all the drama. I think I'm gonna end the episode here and start new. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye. For now. And see you soon. Bye.